Hello. We're the luckiest generation that ever lived. I've been taking the jocular Mickey out of commoner Kate and her family. She's really quite a brave person to get embroiled in what she's gotten embroiled in. The management for profit of the kingdom and the whole world. Yeah, it's a really risky thing to do. All the generations before us have thought nothing of killing and stealing for sectarian reasons. And I've got a whole series of videos here. This is the one that portrays, like the Catholic and Protestant prostitutes that we've told you about with Charles II. Yeah, you've got claimants to the throne, claimants to be the mother of the person who is incapable of siring children. Yeah, because their male bloodline is so evil. The gods have mastery of everything up to that time, and the humans challenge that just by lopping the heads off and remarrying until they get something that can give them an heir. And that's the little James joke. Yeah, just lived into his teenage years, and that's the launch of the sectarian Bible and the biggest genocides of the whole lot. Whole series of videos that bring tears to your eyes when you think back to what it was like, Commoner Kate, even just in the lead up to World War I. Yeah, everyone was unable to have sex unless they are a landowner, and that's the launch of the royal brothels. Okay, I don't want to be too morbid. Yeah, Kate's from a decent family. I know her mum. I know how decent they are. Yeah, and I know how all of them have a good sense of humour, and that's all it takes to change the world, Hannah Rothschild and the rest of your family. Yeah, it does not have to continue any further than our generation. We can have civilization now. Let me take it to the lopping off of her head, and I'll show you Queen Mary on her knees, and then I'll show you how the French do it with the stake and burning the people to death.
Master, I have humbly submit to the law, and the law has judged me.
And Kate and Pippa are fine public speakers.
As for myself, God knows them. Now remit them to God, beseeching you to have mercy on my soul. I beseech Jesus, save my sovereign and master, the King, the goodliest and gentlest master there ever was.
Disgusting. Disgusting. Yet the whole thing is for power and cash. Never ends till our generation and we get into the 1950s.
Thank you.
is the Catholic Mary in the God's colours, and all of it is to divide the people and all the communities around them and all around the world. This is the French Romantic method. Tragic end. All of it is written, yeah, in the history that favours the winners, and all of the losers turn out, yeah, none of the history is documented in an honest way. And that is right back to Tacitus in the Roman court. So up to the stake. And it could not be more brutal. And you sell tickets. Too late, Prince Wills. Yeah, just too late. Yeah, in the helicopter where you're prepared to kill anything that threatens your power base. Yeah, and your mum's a goner already. Okay, and that's just Christianity. Yeah, then we get gunpowder. And the pagans are history. And this is the Forever in Blue Jeans community that make these movies.
Yeah.
I'm going to set up the other computer so we can see why we need eugenics now to do the culls. Okay, it is tragic. Generation that ever lived, and we got up to yesterday the invention of the computers and how they were the size of a room when I started in my scientific career years after we had gone to the moon. All of human history is defrauded and is a lie. Yeah. And that is Rupert Murdoch's press now. Okay, let's get on with the storytelling and the foundations. So we started off with our grandparents' generation, and that is World War II. It's absolutely lethal. Okay, and this is the inquest at Nuremberg, where Martin Bormann's body double was murdered and executed using the firing squad method, and the body double was in the witness chairs watching the whole proceedings for a laugh. Yeah, and that Hewlett-Packard at that time had enough technology in their computers to translate every language on the globe and every combatant country's participation in that massive 50 million war dead campaign. Yeah, they were able to take their evidence and they execute the good guys. It's ever so dangerous marrying into the bloodline that you've chosen, Kate, Commoner Kate. Okay, I've got a lot of admiration for you for that. I'd love you to be on my side, trying to make the next generation even safer than our lives have been. Yeah, two generations back, that massive 50 million dead. Okay, and that takes us to the size of the computers and the moonshot fraud. Okay. So there's, we'll go down and we'll see there's the Hewlett laboratory, Hewlett Packard, and there are the computers the size of a man, yeah, and that is way after we went to the moon, and that's where we got to the last time. Okay, so this is still the Dutch Mafia's but because of my insight into the, all of the economic frauds and the political systems and the economic and fiscal systems all around the world, I can add colour to the sad, sad story, Kate. Okay, let me show you what I've summarised in the last couple of videos on in imagery terms. It's going to be quite embarrassing for your family unless you start making an effort to change the way the world is. So that's the video I made a couple of days ago on the Why Don't You Like Me, Kate stuff. Okay, and I'll take it up to full screen and show you what we've done and what we've seen. Okay, so the illegitimate issues of the monarchy go back now for 164 years, and that's the issues that were reported by Greg Hallett, and that is the stammering king saying not the father. But because this is the wedding for Kate and Wills, pictured there, okay, this is the wedding for Kate and Wills, so I'm going to have to shut the curtains because I'm getting too much glow on it. The sun gods are delighted that the truth is coming out at long last, yeah? There's their representative on this earth, and he's in the genocides in Latin America, yeah? Like the new queen in Spain's family were in the lethal regime led by General Vidal, and the Pope in that era was just Gorgoglio, and he gave him confession. Yeah, it's the killings in the stadia, and this is my sense of humour, because you've got to touch that, otherwise you get what everybody got in the monarchy, and they were deemed to be false claimants, and they get topped. Okay, and it's just tragic. And if you listen to the last videos, numbers 2A, 2B, 3 and 4, yeah, this is number 5 now, you'll see that the McMahons are in the elite family mafias, and that is Monsignor McMahon in the Catholic Church, and we had a Father McMahon in my parish, and the man who sent me the receipt from the Scottish Justice jokes is Sean McMahon, ministerial correspondent. Yeah, do you get it? And he is the son of King Juan Carlos, and he is the son of James Hewitt. That's why I've said, not the father, Prince Charles. Do you get it? Okay, and this is my jocular thing about Pippa's anal itch, and that is my attempt to portray Kate as the prostitute, and I pretend that she is in her birthing gear, and the birthing place for all the elites in Britain is the Lindo wing, where I used to work and where I met Guy Innes Kerr, who was having his second first baby by his second wife, the Welsh woman. Okay, and that's the Lindo wing right next door to St Mary's Hospital, and that's the St Mary the Virgin joke. Isn't it funny that you can have your baby in St Mary's Hospital when she had her babies as a virgin? There's another Martha. That's Princess Grace of Monaco. There is the true love joke. She was killed by the Freemasons because presumably she's a decent and spirited person like Princess Di, the mother of those that are the illegitimate children that are going to be the king someday. And that's lovely Kate in the virginal white dress. Yeah, and that's her in the prostitution den. And that's her dad, who looks like the stammering member of the Vicar of Dibley cast. And Princess Grace, her killing is just unspeakable. And they make films about the true love, and that is part of the empires of sinking ships for profit in the insurance industry. There's Christopher Martin, and that is the man with the golden helmet in Holland, painted by Rembrandt. Okay, so Rembrandt, the man with the golden helmet. This will become a very embarrassing picture for the British royals and the religious fraudsters that pretend that they are not anything to do with the Christopher Martin who had the gun license on the Mayflower and was sent there to kill all of the pagan Indians. It's the soldier blue joke, cut their tits off, and they accuse the Indians of being barbaric. And he runs the massive Bing Crosby war bonds scam, yeah, with Glenn Miller and all of those people that came to Bedford, which is the air balloons joke, yeah. And that is Lily Allen, and you don't get more vicious jokes than Lily Allen on religion and the Vicar of Dibley on religion. That's Lloyd Park, yeah, the wolves joke and the Lloyds of sinking the ships joke, yeah, and the massive debt pool joke. No wonder Lloyd Park died young, and his daughter's in the movies too, and she plays a bitch. And the Indian woman is totally persecuted, even in the gambling dens and nightclubs. Yeah, and the whole of the world's story is really, really dangerous until you get into the 1950s. Okay, so the next one is the other video I've made, and this is on the communist joke for them all. Yeah, and it's the other video I made featuring the music of Micah, Why Don't You Like Me, Kate? And that's Kate, now that I've been sectioned, or they've attempted to section me, taking an interest in mental health in our country. And there is the Radditch that they created by using lobotomy and ECT, and David Cameron's fellows at McGill University in Canada, where they're doing okay in the Bank of England fraud, yeah, they invented ECT as a terror interrogation method. That is Ewan Cameron at McGill University, now used by the CIA and all of the intel agencies in Guantanamo. And she is the freedom fighter that pretends that she had half her head blown out, and it was repaired within days in Birmingham City Hospital, and then within weeks she gives speeches to the United Nations, because she's Gordon Brown's ally, and the whole thing's really sick. And there's Lord Norton of Birmingham. She was cured in Birmingham City Hospital, all of the slaving centres, and he is the template for the Borstal boy made good, becoming the Lord, and the whole of the House of Lords is full of them now. And this is the jokes, sad, sad jokes about the Rothschilds funding communism, then the Rothschilds funding all wars and the battles at Stalingrad, where Stalin was trained in England for cash, yeah, funded by the Rothschilds like Marx and Engels. And there's the funding of Muhammad Ali in India, and the whole world is in the British Empire by then. And this is the Air Force One joke about the stealing of the central bank within hours of his killing, yeah, with his double agent wife sat beside him. Yeah, they have taken off in Air Force One, and that's Harrison Ford's jokes again. Yeah, and they've signed Executive Order 1111, which passes the ownership of the federal banks all across America back to the Rothschilds, who run all the wars. And that one is even a bigger joke, because when they absolutely destroy Stalingrad, there are only 1,500 people left and 1.5 million people are dead. It's and that's the condominium joke, because that is blocks of flats that are left standing as shells. And that is the PISO joke. Condominium and floors and flowers translates as PISO from foreign languages. I've got a whole list of the jocular names for the PISO translations. It's the biggest joke in world history, and that one is the pretend communist in Air Force One. There's the rabbit that she had in the kitchen sink in the movie with Michael Douglas. Yeah, and the Doug is God in the heavens when you reverse it. Dog becomes God when you translate it, the sun has gone in. Okay, it cannot get more fraudulent and more genocidal than that. Commoner Kate, you're really lucky to be alive in this regime, and I want you to make it count. Yeah? The Rothschilds will not lift a finger to reverse what they've done, Hannah. Not lift a finger so far. Okay? So, where did we get to? And you get the revolutionary Red Radditch is the name of the character. She's the deputy president, and Air Force One is stolen by his allies. Yeah, and all of them are founded and funded by the Rothschilds. 1.5 million dead in one battle scene. Yeah, and all of them, Stalin, Hitler and Churchill, are trained in the same places in Britain and Liverpool, and all the Brummy connections and all the Brummy all the fascist connections to the West Coast and Bristol and the slaving centres and the Dutch link to the false Christianity. It's absolutely massive. And there's the Rothschilds' red sign, and they fund everything, in inverted commas. They profit from all of the killings. Which is why you're a really brave person, Kate, and I admire you and your family for smiling through all of the tough times. It's not gotten as tough as it became for the mother-in-law of your current husband, or for Princess Grace, and the rabbit for Winston Churchill was in the fucking sink, and she gets shammed on top of it by the dog joke, yeah. Michael Douglas. Okay, right then. And the Johnsons are in the elite mafias that we're profiling here, so let's get the hell on with that. So intermission, Dutch mafias, we're on the moon, we've got computers the size of a room, and now they fit in your telephone, and we can't get back to the moon, because all of it is a lie. So, the Pasadena Foundation, do you now understand the implications of seeing the word pie, or equivalents of that, changing the spelling of it, yeah, pie or Pearson, or, yeah, so here we've got a Pasadena Foundation, don't know whether that's sinister or not, but these ones all have the pie joke in it. Piton Foundation, Pittsburgh, pie, pie, phi, yeah, and that is the Alpha Kappa Phi jokes about all of the elite graduates, and that is the Amy joke for Britney Spears coming prancing out with her stole on, because all of these people steal from the world, okay? And that's Brad Pitt. He's connected to the elite bloodlines and all the presidential candidates. That's you, hilarious Clinton. Ripley died really young on the rugby pitch, okay? It's a god joke. Do you see that one? Yeah. And that's what Kate had on the front page of the papers, referring to me, that I may not be in contention with them for very much longer. Okay? So that's the Ripley Memorial Foundation. He's a rugby player, plays for, I forget what the name of the place is, but they play right next door to Kew Gardens, where they run the narcotics scams and all of the make new medicines for Dr. Paul Shazo and his colleagues, and they are connected deeply to Chatham House and the Royal Institute for International Affairs, and they used to get me to referee their grant applications until I became wiser than them. There's the Patron Saint of Explosives Foundation, Santa Barbara, yeah, never lived. It's the joke that she is the patron saint of explosives and dynamite. That's the Ali G exposures, okay? All of these funds were given to the massive, powerful, lethal foundations, and they are tiny sums because all of this relates back to 1984, and I'm just topping it up with the facts of everything that has happened since, and almost all of it is constructive until David Cameron, yeah, and Tony Blair came into power. Then everything is tits up. That is a crude expression which I should not use as a moralist. Okay, and all the pits, yeah, all the pits were closed by Mrs. Thatcher, the fascist. And with her friend Pinochet, retired into London.
the award-winning underdog.
Sorry, I hit the wrong button there. Okay, so the shoemaker joke again. Florence and John Schumann. Florence is in the cast of the Zebedee jokes just before every episode of the light entertainment news from Klaus Moser. He's the one that launches all of the jokes about the Nazis, the death camp uniforms for Andy Pandy, and all of the Zionist Dr. Fingley output. Okay, William and Dr. Fingley's people in the practice play the King's champion for a laugh in the huge joke that is El Cid, about people being loyal to their brothers in contention for the kingdom. And that's King Juan Carlos's story. He murdered his elder brother, and he is the father of Prince William. Yeah, and all of it. And their mum is dead at the hands, I'm led to believe, by Greg Hallett, of Prince Philip. Skillman Foundation, 30 grand in 1984. Harry G. Steele Foundation, 418. It's the launch of Tommy Steele and the little white Europa bull. All of the Europa frauds were perpetrated, yeah, way back in those days leading up to 1984. And we were practicing spending the euro and the decimal currency in Hoik, where the royals had the affiliation to blind Prince George of Cumbria, who sired the only legitimate kid of Queen Victoria. You must be memorising that fact now, okay? Eloise and Richard Webber, massive fraudsters. This is the HSB, the Hudson's Bay Company, okay? And it's the HSB, I forget what that stands for, but it's only one letter away from the new Freemasonic Bank that is the HSBC, with the red and white colours for the Rothschilds and the Hudson's Bear companies. Do you get it? The Bear City Rollers. It's the Bay City, yeah? And that is where Madonna was born, and that's the Madonna joke about being the mother of the gods in the heavens now. Okay? Launched globally by the Merchant Adventurers of York. So, Hudson's Bay Company is set up by the same people that send the Pi Pilgrim Fathers to America. Okay? And for a laugh for Rupert Murdoch, it's called Rupert's Land. Do you get that? That's Rupert the Bear, the Bear Rothschild families, and that is Rupert the Bear in the Daily Express, the propaganda event for Lord Beaver Brook. The beavers take wood like Jesus. All of it an interlocking joke, and that is the boundary between California, the Calvary Hill joke, United States, and the corrupted Canadian slaves to the British Crown Templar and the Rothschilds, who are the Bears and the Bay City. And he's the bastard that celebrates in song, yeah, Lloyd Webber, the killing and the diasporas of all of the Nazis through Odessa in the Christmas dream joke. Jesus never lived, there never was a Christmas. It, for the Marx Brothers, is the sanity clause joke. Do you get that? Yeah? And the Freuds are in the sanity clause issues because they are friends of the Prime Minister in Chipping Norton. Let's get going. I want to finish this now and get you on to the really big things. Yeah? When I've profiled Frank Sinatra and the pop singers and the sexual deviancy and the mind control issues in the training centres like Huntsville. Okay, what was that one? So this is the Weber Foundation, and that is the Weber headquarters. It's a retailer. Guess what they sell? Fur coats. Yeah, do you get it? And that's the fur coat. That's Furrious PISO, who was in the Bible fraud family. Okay, Mr. Hudson believed in being a liberal toward many worthy charitable, educational and philanthropic endeavours, and that becomes World War II, with Beaver Brook at the head of the aircraft, munitions, profiteering, and his son in the RAF, which is Raphael, the Jewish angel. And that's Rupert's country, because that is Rupert Murdoch's religion. And it is my sincere hope that this will be a continuing policy through the coming years. Richard Hudson Weber, in 1943, right on the cusp of their last great conflict. World War III is the Freemasonic goal that I'm determined to expose them for. Arthur Hastie, yeah, Creamy Telfer, and all the local Masons. Completely sad what you're prepared to do. Right then. All led by buffoons like Lord Charles Guthrie, who crashes all the bank, crashes all the pensions. There's Metis, the fur trader. Don't know if there's anything sinister about him. There's the fur hat. Okay, same as the World Wildlife Fund. Yeah, there are no people preserving the species. It is all the massive money stream. And all of a sudden, in California, where we have magnificent, huge salmon rivers, there is not a salmon left in their country. Okay, and there is one river, or one or two rivers on the east coast that still have salmon. Only two rivers in that massive continent. All of the rest of them are raped and pillaged, and all of the Indians get what the soldier blues gave them. Rape and pillage everywhere, right up to the 1950s. Thank you for that, Your Royal Highness Queen Elizabeth II. You have the potential for greatness in world history, and I've told you that several times, and that was when you tried to section me. If you ever got the letter from your aides, that's the art, is that the country is run by those guys in the back room. Yeah? You saw the whispering about why Anne Boleyn had to be murdered, and why her sister had to be warned that she would get the same. Okay, there's the culling of the Indians, that's Pocahontas. All of them have got the piezo pipe in their hands already, like Harold Wilson, and everything is the same joke. All the tribes, or many of them, are named after the piezo joke. Yeah, with that pit word at the beginning. And it is endless. Right then. So, the trapper's bride, that picture was. And here's the Odessa joke. This is massive. Yeah, they make the joke about Christmas Dream. They make the joke about laundering the Nazis out. And the man Vogue is the cover for the man who, with Abelard Reuchlin, Vogt, yeah, ran the publishing company that is now being completely taken over by T-Mobile. And that's the T-Christian cross joke. Yeah, I can't do it with one hand. But that is the T Christian cross joke. No, I cannot do it with the camera in hand. Okay, let's get on to the asset stripping of everything that is now privatised. Western Electric Fund, only $6K in dollars in 1984. Robert Wilson Foundation, that's a massive warmongering name in the context that we've just told you about Harold Wilson with the pipe. And Woodrow Wilson comes into every episode that I make. Massive treason against his people and totally against all he pledged in the election. If the reader is wondering what happened to the other top Illuminati families are not on the above list, the reason why is that the other families were supporting other organisations similar to Planned Parenthood Foundation. So can you see how they use the wars as often as they can? And then they use the science to get the numbers down. Yeah? And all of it is in the name of the poor people not being allowed to have anything that they take for granted. For instance, the Rockefeller family runs hundreds, that's the Rockefellers out of the Alps, of foundations. I'm going to have to switch it across a wee bit. Okay? Rockefeller supported the following groups in 1984, which have the same goals and agenda as planned parenthood. I'm going to click on here so I can scan down it. Okay, Centre for Population Options. Oh, that's not going to work. There we go. Okay. Centre for Population Options. Donation given 30 grand then. Population Council 1.2 million. Alan Guttmacher Institute 300,000. This is a dangerous organisation doing research to promote these things. Population Institute only gives 10k. On top of this, the Red Chinese Academy of Medical Science was given several Rockefeller grants to do contraceptive sterilisation and genetic research. So that's the communists in the East, and I've told you about the funding by the Rothschilds of the communists in Russia. Yeah, the whole world is owned by the English speaking nations, and France has a massive chunk because they are opportunists at every opportunity. One of these was a 6647 grant given to the Red Chinese Academy of Medical Science to study male contraceptives, abortion, sterilization, sexual promiscuity. The three studies were made, but maybe we got to the bottom of my written bits. Okay, yeah, we have. Oh, that's a terrible thing to happen. Oh God. So here's the Van Din candies again. I think I'm going to stop there because that's taken me by surprise. It's only 40 minutes in, but I need to prepare it and show you the images, and it will show you the images of Frank Sinatra and all of the Hollywood superstars, totally deviant people, really, really evil people. It was alleged in the Godfather movies that Frank Sinatra was retained as an actor because the Godfather family favoured him and liked his music, and the whole of it is a really, really sinister dance of death. Okay, can you see that? And this is the launch of the sweetie trade. I did not think that I could possibly be down as far as that. The stuff that I learned about the mind control centres and the brainwashing, the day was the last day before I went to Jedburgh Sheriff Court, and when I went to Jedburgh Sheriff Court, they had a body double for Kate in that retailer's called Lovett, okay? And I saw her twice that day, and the second time she was totally mummified, and she was walking with, you know how they put those things for the radio in their ears? She had one in, one out, and when I said hello, she could not even turn her head. Just amazing. Yeah, an absolute likeness for Commoner Kate. Yeah, and that they dispense with the people that are a risk of exposure, and that is the tragic thing. Yeah, I don't know whether my ex-wife has been treated like that, or whether or not they do it voluntarily. Yeah, the member of the clergy that I saw the other day was like a moron zombie too. Okay, that really shocked me that morning. Okay, and they knew that I had read it, and that is why they sent the body double for Kate into Jedburgh. So, God bless you, Kate, and your family, for your spirited efforts to keep our country civilised, and for paying attention to what I'm saying. You should not try and cover it up. We should try together to get rid of it. And I would like Prince Charles to be on my side. He's a softie. Yeah, he's not a violent man. Talk to the trees in the old days like I do now. Yeah, and all that needs to happen is that the decent side of you comes out, and you start to talk to the Rothschilds about making yourselves icons for freedom. It's simple. Yeah, I'm a country boy, I'm a rustic, and it's simple to understand how you have defrauded the world, how it's run by fear and killing, and that needs to stop now, this year. Thank you ever so much for not taking me out thus far. Yeah, and thank you for your courage in marrying into that lineage. Love to talk to your mum. Not about the things that she used to talk to me about, yeah, about the future and how that can be civilization really, really quickly. Okay, I'm going to stop now and I'm going to do some more research on the shocking things that I found about how they take decent people and they turn them into a vegetative state and robotic characters that are just pawns on that chessboard, which becomes the draft board and it becomes the global conflict. And for Creamy Telfer and Arthur Hastie, it becomes World War III, although they will say that they are low-bit characters and it's nothing to do with them. Yet that's their allegiance to the corrupted monarchies that behead the queens in the male gender. That Elizabeth one with the red hair might be an exception to that. Okay? Yeah, she's the one that beheaded even the man that discovered tobacco and made a fortune for them all. Yeah, it's all treason and cheating and killing your loved ones and your closest friends, Harry and Wills. You can put a stop to it too. Yeah, it does not have to be violent. All it has to be is recognition that Queen Elizabeth II has enabled us to demonise people for smacking their children. That is a really constructive step and everything else should follow that suit. Yeah? Gonna stop. Okay? So, we can be rid of it. We can be rid of it forever. And shedding the blame all through all of those social history cover-ups. Yeah? Paul Gascoigne, Adele, yet every one of them is interlocked on the business frauds and right into the chancellery, yeah, that's now a foreign profiteer, yeah, so that they can pretend that it's nothing to do with our indigenous corruption by the super elites who now are the former Borstal boys. Lord Norton, and that's the man that is the Lord, and all of the cover-ups for that are Ken Norton the boxer and Norton for Rebecca and Chipping Norton in the phone hacking. And the T-Mobile thing is really, really sickening. Yeah, that's the Christian Cross Mobile all around the world and a huge joke for all of the world's leaders. Hilly, I wish you well. Yeah, and I hope that the gods are relatively gentle with you because of your policy changes. Yeah, you got to pick a pocket or two, and that's with a spoonful of sugar. Bye-bye.